Association for Educational Excellence Group, known as QE, ever ask the Valdosta Board of Education to take a vote to give up its charter? How is it that only the city residents are the ones voting on this issue?
That's based on the two laws that I mentioned to you earlier. QE chose the one that would not allow the Lyme's citizens to vote on this issue.
Will the city and the county boards wait until after the election to come together and discuss school unification? Speaking to the mic, why don't you?
The answer is no.
If unification was necessary, how do you see community leaders coming together to make a viable plan? If unification was necessary, how do you see community leaders coming together to make a viable plan?
I would hope that both boards would be willing to sit down, open lines of communication, as well as opening up to all stakeholders in the community, all of the county, which includes Valdosta City, any and all that were willing to sit down and participate in that planning should certainly be encouraged to do so and invited to do so, and we should have an open door policy for that.
Let me just say, I believe I've been on the board probably longer than anyone up here, and I'm just as guilty, I guess, as the ones that's not on the board anymore, but I think it's time that, I believe it's time for, you know, things happen for a reason. And it's time that the Valdosta Board of Education realize that we're not playing football. That our concerns, kids' education, academics are number one priority. And regardless of what happens, November, as long as I'm a part of this board, and I hope the board members feel the same way, we'll no longer sit back and not have a dialogue with the Lyons County Board of Education members and their superintendent. So in answering your question, that we will be having a dialogue, and the chairman is aware, and I'm sure the superintendent